Well, evidently there was a network error at some point. But I need copper. Where the fuck am I gonna find copper? Yeah, so basically I need to find some light bulbs, break them down for their copper, and then finish building these parts. Should be some in that house and barn, because there should be some light bulbs or a lamp or two. Nope, need one more piece of copper. Well, I have just unlocked that mod. So, who cares? Now I have a question. Why is this bunker abandoned? I don't know why this bunker was abandoned. And no, it's not the rats. So the vines broke into the bunker, which caused it to flood. So the people who were here just left. And I guess went to a different bunker. Not a bad idea, to be honest.
But
oh well. Heading back to Abby's bunker to finish building these bloody things. And scrap some more stuff and craft some more bulk. And some ammo. Boy, would I like some ammo. Oh no. Game's broken. There we go.
Encountered a lovely Miss Nanny there that goes by the name Rose. I programmed a holotape you want to give her along with the uplink. It explains how she can benefit from all this and get her to help us out. The only way we get that uplink set up is through that Miss Nanny. And finally, once you're done, you get to come all the way back here. Yep, that's right. We're not done yet.
Okay, I'm underway, cool. I like laser weapons. I also like heavy weapons. I've not found a Fat Man yet. I know where one spawns. But I only know where one spawns. Oh, the holotape's in there somewhere. Wasn't very clear that I had to pick up a holotape. Just says take holotape to Rose. It doesn't say find holotape first. Thank you, game. Holotape for Rose. There we go. Can I listen to that holotape for Rose? Doesn't look like it. Oh yeah. I can't read code. Sorry. Yes, we're fast traveling there. I kind of really want to get to level 50. Yeah, there's a hermit crab up on that bridge. Okay, so it'd be quicker to go from Sugar Grove and walk down the hill. Good to know.
What's that?
There's a fucking Scorch Beast as well. I think they know what I'm doing. Workbench here anywhere? Doesn't look like it. Reminder. Note to self. Talk to Abby about JD and Brian. Maybe she can help talk sense into my brother. Brian is no good. I know she's using him, but I don't want... But he doesn't want to listen to me. Abby is smart and JD respects her. She can make him listen. Thank you. probably looking for something. Ah, there's a holotape right there. There it is. That's part three. Right, let's start with part three then. Since there isn't a part one or two. For some reason.
We were at our bunker when the Scourge Beasts attacked Harper's Ferry. It took them less than an hour to burn the place down. When the attack was over, I thought Brianna was dead. And that JD would return to his old self. When he didn't, I became suspicious. Then, Brianna shows up at our cabin with a small group of survivors, and everything became clear. She had conned JD, played him this entire time, pretending to love him, to give herself and her friends an invite to our bunker. Well, there was no way I was gonna let that happen. I told her she could march right back to her cave and find her own place to survive. When JD tried to stop me, I had to knock him out. That's when Brianna's people pushed back, and I fired some shots in the air to scare them away. Now I have to deal with JD. Damn, is he gonna be pissed? It's been weeks since I chased off Brianna Hawk, and I feel like I've wasted all of it trying to convince JD that he was better off without her. I finally thought I was getting through until I was cleaning up our cabin and found the goddamn notes they've been passing to each other. Instead of heading out to hunt, that hijo de perra has been stabbing me in the back by giving Brianna some of our supplies. After everything I've sacrificed for our family, how could he do this to me? When he gets back from today's hunt, we're gonna have a little chat about Brianna Hawk. And this time, I'm not just gonna look the other way.
You need to kill her, mate.
I don't even know how to say it, but... JD's dead. Murdered my own brother.
Damn.
After I found out he'd been stealing our supplies for Brianna Hawk, I couldn't wait. So I rushed out and found him scouting the ridge. I have a hard time remembering the rest. I don't know if he slipped pushed him too hard, but my brother, he fell. He's dead, and it's all my fault. When Brianna found out what happened, she gathered her group and hit the cabin with everything they had. They wanted me dead. I killed them all.
Good.
But they got in a lucky shot.
And
I don't think I'm gonna last that much longer. Probably me of a passage I read in the Bible once. Everyone who hates his brother is a murderer. And you know that no murderer has eternal life present in him. I guess I proved that one right.
You're an idiot. Then he promptly died. Brewmat, okay. Juan Diego, Brewmaster's Log, The Plan. I've convinced Jesus that if we're really doing this backward survival gig, we gotta go all the way. And when I say all the way, you know I'm talking about Moonchan. On the downside, everything I read says making shrine takes time, but practice doesn't exactly run in the Sunday blood. Time to find a guy who knows a guy. There's got to be a way to speed this up. The distills. Best news all day. Our cousin Carmen's got a roommate at VTU who's more than willing to take on our little distillation problem. She said an engineering major who can hold more than her fair share of liquor. I admit I admire her already, and even more so if she manages to pull this off. The mission. They were right. Raleigh and Sam were actually right. The Reds dropped the bombs, the world's gone to shit, and believe me, people need shine. Now more than ever. I had to change up the recipes a bit since Mother Nature's gone a little loopy, but they still work. But damn, this world's gone crazy. Jesus is loading up the shotguns. The stills get the wildlife all riled up. So if we want to make this, we need to protect it with everything we've got. And the results. The new recipes aren't the worst. Muttberry's actually still pretty damn good. It's just the tater shine that makes you want to spit it out faster than you can drink it down. Hell, it serves a purpose. Only issue now is we're running low on ammo. And this is man versus nature on a whole new level. I'm not sure how many batches we got left in us, but I'm guessing we can trade it up for some nice supplies at Harper's. I can get Brianna to put it up on the forum that old man Hayes threw together. We got moonshine if you got money. Choo choo, motherfucker! Oh, come on, game. Game is getting real laggy. I don't particularly want to mess about in Harper's Ferry at the minute. did that miss? Keep moving. I still need to craft a load of ammo. on, that truck's about to explode. Scrap that. You might be asking yourself, why would you scrap the black powder rifle? Well, I don't have any ammo for it, for a start. Okay. Didn't want that. Just wanted the shotgun. And shotgun ammo. Yeah, I have a level up. Bull. it's the last rank of that. That uses 9 intelligence points. I then have 3 spare. Okay. Might seem a bit funny at the minute, but it'll make sense later. When I get some more perks. Go in that tree. There's no point keeping ammo I can't use, because I can't sell it, for some reason. So I guess a sinkhole opened up underneath the road. Almost at the last one. Oh, it's a shopping centre. Or mall for you Americans. Okay, so it's around. There it is. Last one. Now what? Give holotape to Rose. Okay, so go to aid, disease cure, get into the power armor. Don't do that. Fast travel to the top of the world. And I have, like, no grenades. I'm just gonna avoid that fight. Now, these guys almost always have grenades. Which is useful, because I need grenades. Hello, Madigan.
What a disappointment that my gang friends left behind such crap in that cache of theirs. I don't know what I expected.
I guess it's kind of funny they thought they'd actually be able to return to normal life after the world went and got destroyed.
For me? How thoughtful! Now, let's see. It doesn't appear to be a virus. I could scan for... You know what? Screw it. I could use some excitement. You see? Told you that gal was smart. Like I said, can't rebuild the raiders with Scorched crawling all over the place.
True.
Plus, it's not like I'm risking my life here.
Always you are a robot.
So, looks like you got yourself a deal. I'll just take that little uplink off your hands. Abby included instructions on how to install it. Not like I need them. So, you're off the hook there. I guess all you have to do is make it back to her bunker for the next steps. You hear that, Madigan? It's mission accomplished after all!
Yeah, he's a psycho. And he was in the Brotherhood, apparently. Back to Appalachia. Oh, frag. Sneak, sneak, sneak. Book it. Okay. Go back to Abby's bunker. I think I've unequipped one of the legs of my power armor somehow.
You upgraded the Scorch detectors and got Rose to cooperate with the uplink. A pretty impressive accomplishment. Not that I can confirm it. Next on the list, the Scorch Detection Network. Something's gotta link this all together, right? First step is geek. Look in my desk for a holotape labeled Master. It's got everything you're gonna need to get this done. Then, you're heading to the old armory in Harper's Ferry. You'll need to install the program called Armory Access on the main entrance terminal to get inside.
Huh.
Once it's been uploaded and installed, I've got another recording set up for you, so make sure you're safe enough to hear it. We fled from Harper's after a Scorch Beast attack, so who knows what lives there now. Be careful.
Really? I didn't know squirrel on a stick. Whatever. Okay, take the master holotape. Load it into the armory terminal. I'm I'm gonna need to go do some real quick inventory management at my base. Because I am relatively close to being over encumbered again. And it will be cheaper to travel to Harper's Ferry from my camp. Spawn me down the bottom, I can pick up some copper. Since I know that I have no copper left. Or virtually none. Is it spawned? Yes, it has. Okay, so I keep removing limbs from power somehow. Whatever. I still need dogwood. Right leg. Okay, 32 is the heaviest. Ah! That's quite a bit better, in fact. Can't do leaded because I don't have enough lead. So I won't bother. Okay, so that very much was worth it. Versus 69. That can't be upgraded. It is lightweight. That's pocketed. Could make it ultra lightweight if I had enough perks. Or pneumatic if I had enough lead. It says I do because I can create it. Weird. Pocketed spine. Yeah, I'm gonna go with that. I'm gonna wear that. So, wear that. Go there. Go to that. Scrap it. Ah. I have somewhat of a lack of adhesive now. Fortunately, I have an adhesive farm. That's enough just to repair my weapons. Quite enough of that. Craft. Really have no acid at all. Guess not. That's kind of weird. One's Raider, one's T-60. Let's figure out which is which. Okay, so that's the Raider one. That's the T-45. And that's the T-60. Okay, apparel. Helmet, torso. Yeah. So I've just got the torso. I've not actually worn that T-45 at all. Mainly because I don't have a helmet for it, and that's bloody tedious, not having a head torch. Well, not having a light when you need one. So I can go in there then. Can I make hammer? Apparently not, because I need lead. Oops. Yeah, no, I need lead. I've got a real lead shortage. I do need some more grenades. I'm encumbered, not by as much as I was. Plenty of carry weight and power armor, I believe. Oof. Oh. the Harper's Ferry. Oh, I didn't set up any of my favourite hotkeys. Whoops. This might be problematic, because I don't know if I have a weapon equipped. Right. Rifle, grenades. Get that first. Welcome to Harper's Ferry, where I need to get real close to everything to kill it. Is that a wind turbine or a sensor of some kind? Because I'm not entirely certain. Movement. Blue permutants. Grenades do you have, mate?
Show up. I'd rip his legs clean off.
One up there. I think there's one right above me. Hello. I'll take that.
What? Who's there?
above me, it's over there, yeah. Ah, one of the missiles has fallen into the toilet. Press F. Game. Game's having a bit of a think and an odd time. And dog food. There's a radio somewhere. I don't know where it is. For a different way into the town and approach that situation from a different angle.
Territory now. No government interference here.
Good to know. Daisy Cutter.
You should take on your survival into your own hands. Stock up on supplies. You looking to buy everything is tax-free. Regulations keep you safe, but all it does is cede power to bureaucrats. Need supplies or just here for my
soothing voice.
You purchased from me. You won't regret it. And if you do, no refunds.
Why'd I do that? Right, let's try and find that radio to turn it off. Where are you, radio? You're upstairs, I'm guessing. Why are you playing the American National Anthem when these guys were clearly a bunch of secessionists who left the United States formally because they handed in documentation that said they were seceding? Where is this radio, for fuck's sake? I'm trying to turn it off. Where is it? Stupid bloody Bethesda! Make a game properly! I mean, it's not like I have all music turned off in the game, and radios. To try and, you know, prevent music from playing in the game that would get me copyrighted. But fuck you, Bethesda. You say no. That's not how game works. Was it out here somewhere, maybe? Oh, you're a legendary. This is gonna be a fight. Turns out you hadn't gone through the process and mutated yet. Might be upstairs, might not be. Not that it matters because I can't get up there. So, yeah, it doesn't matter if it's up there because I can't get to it, for fuck's sake. God damn it, Bethesda. Words mean things.
Finally starting to shape up around here at Harper's Ferry. We got a lot of defenses up and running, a real perimeter, and people taking lookout ships. Nearish is working on some new contraption to help with these brutal storms that sweep through. He said they could filter the air or something. And Ella's got a decent clinic set up with the help of the responders. Makes me feel like maybe Riley was right. We can have a real go at this. Some of these survivors, they aren't completely worthless. One guy, Duncan, turned out to be a decent runner. Another gal, he's a better shot than me. Still, look at these guys. Thank you. You bastards had your chance. We practically spelled it out for you. You just turned your noses up and called us crazy. Idiots.
Because you do come across as fucking crazy. All Doomsday Sayers do. Just kind of how saying things are gonna end goes. Don't get me wrong, they set up one hell of a defensive maze here. I mean, that's one way of winning a fight. If your enemy can't get to you, he can't exactly fight you, and thus he can't win. It also means you can pick him off whilst he's trying to navigate the clusterfuck of a maze that you've made to get to you. Yeah, that's how you build a trench, basically. Greatest defensive structure there is, the trench network. A single trench by itself can be easily taken, but a trench network? Not so easily. Particularly if it's been built, well, constructed. Thank you. That was a hell of a firefight, and I'm almost out of ammo again. Fuck. Getting late. It's quarter, well, it's 10 to 1 now. So I am going to finish for the evening, well, for the morning, technically. And I will probably see you later today, today being Monday. I will probably see you at about 6 o'clock GMT, probably. Right. I will see you later. Bye.